I'm Lynn Kelly, and I'm a recovering court reporter. Caregiver for two of my grandchildren, an independent consultant for an amazing health and wellness company, and a children's author. Oh. Highlights Magazine awarded me Author of the Month for my short story, The Hobo Tree, and I've published 5 books, 3 as co-author of the Monster Moon Mystery Series under the pseudonym B.T.H. McChiller. My memory isn't the best, especially when I'm scared stiff to step out of my comfort zone, so I brought along my pet Brain for support. Okay, Brain, stay. A few years ago, Brain and I got to take part in 2 Homework Hotline episodes for a local TV station. Brain was a big hit, along with my Monster Moon co-authors, Kathy and Maria. I had an important part too. Cue card girl. That's right, I was too chicken to be on camera. Just holding the cue cards gave me the jitters. As it turned out, the teleprompter messed up, so I saved the day. Go cue card girl! But I'm getting ahead of myself here, so let's go back. Way back to the olden days when I was a girl. Abracadabra, presto pachilo! With a magician grandfather, is it any wonder my childhood was magical? Not only did Granddad perform magic tricks, but he was always working on creative projects, like one time he cut the legs off a coffee table and replaced them with women's mannequin legs. Oh. In those days, I was a skinny, freckle-faced kid, and my dad was Mr. Funny Guy. In my eyes, Jerry Lewis had nothing on Dad. He made up a little song about me that always made me giggle. Skinny Lynnie, there she goes, walking down the street like a bag of bones. It still makes me giggle. Being skinny didn't bother me, and neither did my freckles, but I had this mole on my neck that stuck out like a skin tag, and I must have whined about it a lot, because for my 8th birthday, my mom gave me a choice. Do you want a birthday party, or do you want to get that mole cut off your neck? I had never had a birthday party before, so of course that's what I chose. And imagine if I hadn't, and my friends would have asked, so what'd you get for your birthday? I got a mole cut off my neck. Ew! Still, I was confident, athletic, and spunky. Until junior high, when I turned into a dorky dweeb and regretted not having that mole cut off. I've always loved costumes and playing with makeup around Halloween. So when I grew up and was going to court reporting school, I thought I'd earn some extra money working as a clown. But that was short-lived because everybody just laughed at me. I moved on and life was good. I worked as a court reporter for 25 years. My husband George and I will celebrate 38 years of marriage next month. We raised 4 rascals and now have 4 grandchildren, ages 4 and under. And 1 on the way.
Oh, okay.
I'm caregiver for 2 of them. I get to be the biggest goofball ever, and they love it. I wonder if I will influence them the way Granddad's creativity inspired me. A few weeks ago, I saw a post on Facebook that said, if you've ever wondered what a creative person's mind feels like, just imagine a browser with 2,850 tabs open all the time. What a great analogy. So what tabs might be lurking in this quirky mind? A pirate ditty for my next book? A new chocolate smoothie concoction? A time travel adventure? Or maybe a new Funny Bones video for YouTube? My Funny Bones character is a numbskull skeleton who carries a bag of bones. Each bone has a joke on it. It seems Dad's little song about me proved to be prophetic. And one day, it dawned on me, Funny Bones is actually a clown skeleton. Go figure. The future is wide open, and I've got lots of stories itching to be told. I hope to leave a legacy for my grandchildren, my great-grandchildren, and all children. All my goals are within reach. Now that I'm feeling better thanks to the pea protein shakes I drink every day. For the record, folks, that's pea, spelled P-E-A. The pea protein shakes have taken away my sugar cravings. My sweet tooth is so big, it's more like a fang. And now that it's been tamed, I've lost 15 pounds in 4 months, and my energy level is so much better that I can do extra things, like join Toastmasters. Fellow Toastmasters, I want to thank you for such a warm welcome into this club. I look forward to being on this adventure with you. I have a little gift for each of you when I'm finished. A bookmark from one of my books. But first, I must click my heels 3 times and wait for the flying monkeys to carry Brain and me back to our seats. There's no place like my comfort zone. Thank you.